Let's say I want a very basic multivitamin to cover, like my, like you say, it's at gaps.
Yeah.
So my multivitamin. So there's different multivitamins. One costs $9 for a month.
Sure.
And one costs $50 for a month.
Yep.
Is there a difference? Is it just making more money for the producer, for the owner of
yes,
the company?
Yes. No. No.
But yeah, what's your opinion?
So yeah. So my take on that is, like anything, you have all different types of. How do you prepare this? The standard multivitamin that you might pick up at a big box store, at a discount store, these are what are called USP, United States Pharmacopoeia. They are isolated versions of what you might find in food. Here's what I mean. If you eat an orange or a pepper, you're getting vitamin C. Vitamin C is a compound. It has a whole bunch of stuff. If we look at it under a microscope, it looks a certain way. If you grab ascorbic acid, which a lot of people probably think of as vitamin C, they pick up their bottle, it says vitamin C as ascorbic acid.
Kind of the cheapest version of vitamin C, quote unquote.
Yeah, well, it's actually a part of vitamin C. It's not vitamin C. Picture a pie, it's the shell.
Okay.
It's not the filling, it's not anything else that goes in there. So if we're going out to dinner, I know you said don't eat sugar, but it's my analogy.
Yeah.
If I give you a pie versus I give you a pie shell, or I give you the flour,
yeah,
that's probably even better way to look at it. I give you the flour and I say, these are the same.
Mm-hmm.
No, the flour's in the pie, but give me the pie, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So that's what ascorbic acid is. It has benefit, but it doesn't have the benefit of a whole food. What am I getting at? There are all different types of preparations of vitamins out there. There are the ascorbic acids. There are the whole food vitamin C's. So when you look at a multivitamin, there are ways to tell whether or not you're getting a USP isolate, which is good, but you gotta take a high dose and you gotta make sure that there are no binders, fillers, artificial colors. If you look at some of the most popular one-a-day type vitamins.
I wanna roll my eyes right now, but I get it.
They've got synthetic versions. They don't even have real like D-alpha to count for. They have DL-alpha. It's very complicated, but they've got, you've got dextrose. Why are you, it's not chewable. Why are you putting sugar in it, right?
I know.
Artificial this, artificial that. So you've got your USPs, but then if you go up, then you have the USPs where they've added some food, which is cool. You're gonna increase the body's ability to recognize and use. And then you've got what we call whole food, or not what we call, but what is called a whole food vitamin. This is a vitamin that's created in a way where you're actually getting the whole vitamin C compound.
Okay.
So you get a much more active, and that's why we're taking supplements, right? We're taking supplements to fill these gaps and to get something out of them. And a whole food type vitamin is gonna give you by far the best utilization, not absorption, but utilization. You're gonna get both, and that's super important.